Hello everyone. In this video, we will discuss treatment of medical benefits under perquisites. Meaning of perquisites. Perquisites come under the head salaries. The term perquisites has not been defined under Income Tax Act 1961. It means any benefit or any casual emolument attached to an office or position in addition to salary or wages. Perquisites denotes a personal advantage. These may be in cash or in kind or goods or services or in the form of amenities. When these are given in the form of cash, these perquisites are known as allowances. But when these perquisites are given to employees in the form of goods, services or amenities, which should be measurable in monetary terms, these are known as perquisites or in short, perks. According to Oxford English Dictionary, perquisite is any casual emolument, fee or profit attached to office or position in addition to salary or wages. Perks are chargeable to tax under the head salary under Section 17, Subsection 2 if these are received by an employee from his or her present, past or prospective employer. Perquisites can be given voluntarily or under a contractual obligation. These may be given to employees either in lump sum or monthly. It would be chargeable to tax even if employee's family is getting this benefit. Remember that if these perks are being received from employer under employment agreement, only then these perks would be considered under this head. Otherwise, these perks would be taxable under either profit and gains of business or profession or under income from other sources. Types of perquisites. Number one is exempted for all employees. Perquisites taxable for all employees. And third one is taxable only for specified employees. In this video, we will discuss only about exempted perks. Perks exempted for all employees or exempted perks. Exempted perks is not a part of salary. So these perks are exempt from tax. These are free medical facility or reimbursement of medical expenditure. This benefit is allowed to employee, spouse, children. Children may be dependent or independent, married or unmarried, brothers and sisters and parents. Please note that with effect from 2019-2020, medical reimbursement by employer will be treated as perquisite and it is taxable. This exemption regarding medical reimbursement has been discontinued. Medical facilities in India. If medical treatment was taken by employee from a hospital which is maintained by employer or central government or state government or local authority or government approved hospital, then it shall be fully exempted. Diseases specified in Rule 3A and treatment was taken from a hospital which is prescribed by Principal Chief Commissioner or Chief Commissioner of Income Tax, then it shall be fully exempted. If under a scheme approved by central government, employer pays a employee's medical health insurance premium, in that case it shall be fully exempted. If medical health insurance premium is paid for employees by employer to General Insurance Corporation under notified scheme, then also it is fully exempted. Now, let us look at illustration number 1. Mr. Mahesh is an employee getting a salary of ₹65,000 per month. He is receiving medical allowance at the rate of ₹700 per month. During the year, Mr. Mahesh met with an accident and his employer made the payment directly to the private hospital of ₹10,000. Mr. Mahesh also incurred medical expenses on the treatment of his dependent grandfather ₹5,000, on the treatment of his sister ₹2,000 and on the treatment of his wife ₹4,000. Employer took medical insurance for all of his employees and paid premium of ₹7,000 per annum on each policy of employee. From the information given above, explain the treatment of medical benefits received by Mr. Mahesh. Now, the question has been asked that explain the treatment of medical benefits. We will write it as, because question is given in statement form, so we have to answer it as per the rules which is discussed in theoretical part. Before applying any treatment, just go through the rules and provisions which are given in the theoretical portion. When rules and provisions are clear, then it is easy to attempt numerical. So we will make a table over here consisting of four columns. Serial number 1, serial number, statements or particulars of Mr. Mahesh. Treatment means whether taxable or not. If taxable, then with how much amount. In amount column, we will write that amount which is taxable and it shall be part of total income. Alright, let's focus on our illustration. As per point 1, we will write over here, medical allowance received by Mr. Mahesh is rupees 700. We will multiply it with 12 and this will be equal to 8400, and as we know, this is fully taxable. Now, the second point is, employer made the payment of rupees 10,000 directly to private hospital. This is also fully taxable in the hands of Mr. Mahesh. Rupees 10,000 will be written in the amount column. Third point is, treatment of his dependent grandfather. In this case, grandfather does not fall in the category of employee's family. The whatever the amount of medical benefit he is receiving from his employer is fully taxable in the hands of Mr. Mahesh. So we will write it 5,000 in amount column. Next, rupees 2,000 incurred on the treatment of his sister. It will also be fully taxable and it is written in the amount column, rupees 2,000. Rupees 4,000 incurred on the treatment of his wife. It is also fully taxable and we will write rupees 4,000 in the amount column. Last point is, medical insurance premium of rupees 7,000 paid by employer for the policy taken for all employees and their family members. This is fully exempted and no amount will be written in the amount column. Next, medical facilities outside India. If the employee or any of his family member visited abroad for medical treatment and medical expenses are paid or reimbursed by employer, it is exempted to the extent of RBI's permission. This is the rule. Expenses incurred on the stay of patient and one attendant paid or reimbursed by employer, it is also exempted to the extent of RBI's permission. Third point is, employer reimburse the expenditure actually incurred by employee either on the treatment, that is point A, or for travelling abroad, that is point B. It is exempted to the extent of RBI's permission. Treatment of medical benefit if the treatment is outside India. Illustration number 2. Mr. Mahesh is an employee getting a salary of rupees 65,000 per month. During the year, Mr. Mahesh met with an accident and he was referred to a specialist doctor in USA. An employer met the expenses on travelling of employee and one attendant, rupees 80,000. Operation fee of doctor was rupees 35,000. Hospitalization and medical expenses, rupees 55,000. RBI permitted an expenditure of rupees 1 lakh. From the information given above, explain the treatment of medical benefits received by Mr. Mahesh. Now, in this case, Reserve Bank of India permitted an expenditure of rupees 1 lakh only. But the expenditure incurred on operation of Mr. Mahesh is rupees 55,000 and hospitalization and medical expenses is rupees 35,000. Total expenditure incurred is rupees 90,000. In this case, and third one is, expenses on traveling of employee and one attendant is Rs. 80,000. Rule: only that extent of amount is exempted which is permitted by RBI. Over and above shall be taxable. Here the total medical expenditure incurred is Rs. 55,000, 35,000 and 80,000. This will be equal to 1,70,000. Whereas, as we know, in the question, it has been given that RBI permitted only for Rs. 1 lakh. So, as per the rule, firstly, cost of medicine and hospitalization expenses plus operation fee shall be adjusted. After that, traveling expenses shall be considered. Rest shall be taxable per. That is, we will deduct 1 lakh out of 1,70,000. The remaining amount will be 70,000. So, taxable amount will be 70,000. And exempted, that is, rest of will be exempted. 70,000 will be taxable in the hands of employer. Now, remaining perks will be covered in upcoming videos. Thank you very much. Take care. Keep watching my channel for more videos. Keep learning. Don't be scared. Be prepared. Thank you very much.